First of all, congrats on this film. It's pretty epic. Louise, this is a major achievement for you. You're starring in this film and you also wrote and directed it. How did you come up with the idea for it?
You know, I've always been a big fan of the femme fatale genre, you know, from the earlier movies like Double Indemnity with Barbara Stanwyck, or Leave Her to Heaven with Jean Tierney, or Gloria Swanson in Sunset Boulevard, all the way up to the 90s films like Basic Instinct with Sharon Stone. I took all of these different characters that I found so compelling and so intriguing and so fun to watch because they're so diabolical, and I wanted to make a character that's sort of like an ode to all of them, an homage to all of them, but with comedy.
And then Ed, what drew you to this project and this role?
It just sounded like a really exciting concept, and I don't think I've done like a lot of comedy. And so at that point, I was really kind of interested in exploring that more. And so I went and had the meeting with Louise, having read the script, and I just was blown away by, you know, her personality and her ideas for the film, her vision for the film. And it just sounded really, really exciting and a challenge, which I love. You know, as an artist, I want to grow and go on these adventures. And this seemed like that. I mean, this is essentially, there are supporting members of the cast, supporting characters, but for a lot of the film, it's just us two. And that's something that I hadn't really done before as well. So I was really up for kind of seeing what that would be like and going on this challenge. And then I've got a dance number, we've got like a 20 minute fight scene and everything like that, and it just all sounded like, you know, a completely new challenge. So all of those reasons.
Well, it was really fun to watch. And Louise, your character is a hedge fund manager, and there's been some wild stuff going on with GameStop and Wall Street. What do you think your character's reaction would be if that had happened in the film?
I'm not sure. I mean, Catherine's a pretty ballsy gal, and she likes to take risks. I'm not entirely sure what she might have done. She probably would have jumped in on it.
And then, what was it like for you both working together on set? I've seen some photos of you guys on social media. It seems like you got along really well.
We got along really well. I mean, it was hard not to get along on this one. You know, I mean, we have these wacky characters who falling in love in the most strange of circumstances. We were shooting in beautiful Malibu. We really had a, you know, really close-knit group on the movie, you know, in terms of the crew. Everyone was just, you know, everyone knew that we had to work hard, we had to get it done. We only had a limited number of days. And then all of a sudden the Malibu fires happened, which were a great tragedy for the area. And we had to pause filming and we took a break, and then we went back when everything was safe and right to do so. And you know, it was a kind of like a family kind of getting back together and finishing the job. So everyone had a great great rapport on set, and I love seeing these photos from it, you know, whether they're the ones on social media or stuff we've got for EPK and everything. It's just, there was a great atmosphere. I'm really, really fond of it.
It's funny when we look back at the behind the scenes footage, I think some of it we're going to share with that in social media, but it always brings a smile to my face because Ed and I are always either high-fiving or laughing, or we're singing along to the lyrics and the songs, but we just had so much fun together and with these characters, and became good friends in real life as well as being in love in the movie. We became great friends in real life. And I've got to also say, you know, I learned a lot from Ed. You know, he has a lot more experience as an actor than I do, and he was so professional, and I really learned a lot from him.
And then Ed, we have to ask, his fans are dying to know, the upcoming Gossip Girl reboot, is there any chance you might make a cameo? Fans really miss Chuck Bass.
Yeah, do you know what? I'm starting to miss Chuck Bass as well. I think it would be a very cool idea. I haven't been approached, you know, really about it. So this is very much its own thing, and I wish them all the best. I'm very excited to see what they do. I've been in touch with the creators. I'm just wishing them the best, Josh and Stephanie, and I know they're excited. So look, I mean, I would never say no. But yeah, at this moment, there's nothing to report.
And then looking back at that show, it was such an iconic role and TV series when it was on. Do you still keep in touch with the other cast members?
A little bit from time to time, you know. It's funny how you know, life happens, right? I mean, everyone's off kind of doing their thing, and but you know, I see them on social media and sometimes at events, and yeah, we talk from time to time. And as long as everyone's healthy and happy, I'm happy, you know, and that seems to be the case.
For all the people who are madly in love with Chuck Bass, and that seems to be everybody, wait until you meet Tyler Jones. My goodness. Because he's even more lovable.
I really think a lot of fans of the original Gossip Girl are going to love this film. I know that's one of the reasons I was so drawn to watch it. And your guys' on-screen chemistry is great. Off-screen chemistry, fans are obsessed, Ed, with your relationship and all your nice posts on social media. Your girlfriend recently posted about how you both met. What made you want to slide into her DMs?
I mean, if you've seen her, why wouldn't you want to?
Lastly, jumping back to the film, how would you describe the film in three words?
Colorful, playful, self-aware.
Electric, madness, hot.